What is it that people say to you, leaders of other countries, when they look at American politics?
Well, they're very concerned, Charlie. There's a great disquiet, I mean, anxiety right now.
What are they anxious about?
They're anxious that the certainty that they've had about United States policy. You give me an example. I mean, I will say one thing about a policy issue that a candidate has said. When Donald Trump talked about Korea and Japan going out and getting their own nuclear weapons, I can't think of anything that would be more volatile, more contrary to peace and stability of the region, more contrary to the fundamental commitment of every president since World War II to try to minimize the risk of nuclear weapons and minimize the number of people who have them. And here's a guy running for president just says, oh, you know, let them go get them themselves.
Like Japan.
Yeah. And it's beyond provocative, and that absence of continuity and stability
with American traditional
foreign policy and with risk assessment, with calculated strategy, is a profound challenge
so
to
what
the
would
relationships
they do, these
we
leaders,
have.
If Donald Trump somehow should become the nominee?
Well, I'm not going to go down that road at this point. I think suffice it to say that there is great anxiety. Everywhere I go, people say, what has happened in the United States? What's happened to your politics?
Yeah, but it's happening in Europe, too. We see the move to the right because of the refugee situation.
Yeah. But you see a move to the right, but you don't see people recommending that other countries get nuclear weapons and go out and fend for themselves. And you don't see an assault on NATO, which is engaged with us in Afghanistan, engaged with us in Iraq, very important now to the effort to hold the migration at bay. And so I think those are the things. When people see a potential nominee of a party starting to talk that way, they get nervous.